いろんな部品車を作る上ではありますので、まあ、そういった一点一点を少しずつコストカットしながら、あのお金をかけるところにはお金をかけるし、あの節約できるところは節約するといった、そういった開発をしています。
Torej, tudi v ta mali mestni avtomobil so vgradili vso znanje, kar ga premore ta Toyotina prestižna znamka, pa naj stane, kolikor hoče. To pomeni, da tudi ta mali mestni avtomobil vsebuje vso tehnologijo, ves tist Lexusov šarm, kar ga ponuje tudi tisti te veliki Lexusi, naprimer RX. In to lahko potrdim že tudi po nekaj kratkih teh mestnih kilometrih. Ampak naj vam vseeno dam nekaj konkretnih primerov.
So first of all, in terms of materials, definitely we choose the best, either semi-aniline leather or real leather or vegan leathers. There's different options in terms of premium material equipment that are unique to Lexus. In terms of technologies, you have, for instance, something which he called the predictive efficient drive, which is analyzing in real time how the driver behaves. And it's also combining that with real-time information about the road conditions. And it even remembers where you've been the day before and the day before, etc. And the result is that it maximizes the use of electricity, of the battery.
V določenih pogledih pa je tale mali avtomobil celo boljši od tistih večjih Lexusov.
When you brake, what is super annoying is you dive and then you are in urban traffic, you know, you keep on doing like this. With this vehicle, you keep a horizontal line all of the time because the brake force between the front and the rear is automatically calculated in order to keep this very linear posture. Again, it's a very exclusive Lexus technology.
Torej, ta avtomobil se med vožnjo ne gunca, se pravi naprej, nazaj, levo, desno in seveda ostaja stabilen med vožnjo. In zagotovo bo všeč to tudi tistim, ki ponovadi med vožnjo občutijo slabost. Seveda pa sem vam zdaj dolžen povedati, kje se nahajamo in seveda smo v Valenciji, v Španiji in to, kar vidimo tukaj okrog mene, je mesto umetnosti in znanosti, delo izjemnega arhitekta Santiago Calatrave. In seveda ta lokacija je še kako primerna za znamko Lexus, namreč pri Lexusu je umetnost in pa tehnologije so gredo nekako z roko v roki. In seveda, vedno ponovadi pri Lexusu poslušamo neke japonske besede, ki izhajajo seveda iz načel japonske filozofije in Lexus to japonsko filozofijo zna odlično nekako utelesiti, da jo potem mi lahko gledamo in pa tudi otipamo. No, predlagam, da jo na primeru LBX-a najprej pogledamo.
Kagami Moshi is a rice cake. You have that in Japan, mostly around New Year, and it's basically two rice cakes on top of each other, a fat one and a smaller one on top of it. And if you look at the car, especially from the back, you will recognize a bit that type of stance. Tazuna in Japanese means the reins of a horse. So the idea is that you are driving the car as if you would drive a horse. And what is important is that you can always keep your eyes on the road in front of you or the way in front of you. You never have to look around to find the commands. So this system is implemented as a philosophy in the dashboards of our recent models. For instance, one example is you have on the dashboard, you have some switches, right? When you want to use those switches, you don't have to look at them because in the head-up display, it will show that you are looking, that you are touching those creatures.
Je rekel, da avto vozimo, kot bi vozili konja, ampak to seveda še ne pomeni, da bomo vozili takole, sploh pa tistega volana oziroma krmila, ki ga ponuja v Lexusu RZ v tem avtomobilu, ne bomo dobili. Volan bo ostal okrogu. Da pri razvoju LBX-a niso šparali, je seveda zelo, zelo strateška odločitev v zadnje. Namreč ta avtomobil bo seveda prodajal tudi druge večje Lexuse. Pri zvišanju tržnega deleža pa jim je pomagal celo Audi, s tem, ko je iz tega razreda umaknil model Q2.
LBX was developed a little bit outside of the traditional segment definition. So it can cover from B CB SUV. So in that way, I really expect a lot more customer would start to look into Lexus, including those people who felt the hurdle was too high to approach Lexus. We prepared quite a competitive proposition. From the end of November, we started the online booking. Within less than 1 month, already we gained quite a interest to LBX, thankfully. So the booking was almost filled half of the total portion we planned for next year. But it was quite a positive signal that we are now sensing how market is reacting to us.
Torej, pri Lexusu nas zdaj vabijo, da obiščemo prodajni salon. Recimo tistega v Ljubljani, v katerem je po novem resničnost digitalno oplemenitena. In seveda, ko boste prišli tja, boste videli, da imate dva para vrat. Skozi eno boste vstopili k Toyoti, skozi druga pa k Lexusu. In pri Lexusu zdaj pravijo, pridite in pa otipajte.
In terms of quality standards, they are super high for Toyota and a little bit higher for Lexus. The margins that we allow from perfection is even smaller for Lexus. We have what we call Takumi in Lexus, which are people that have 25 years of experience at least in their skills. And we have those in all the Lexus factories, and they are there to really guarantee the quality and also to train the other workers on the line. We are very proud that we have a very precise management between gaps, the gaps between two different parts of the car, right? If it has to be 2.7 millimeters, it's not 2.5 millimeters. And we have people who have fingers trained to really see the difference. And they can go on cars that are on the production line, they can see this is 2.5, this is 2.7, this is 2.6. You and I would never be able to recognize that kind of difference, but we have people trained to do that.
Razliko pa boste začutili že ob samem vstopu v salon. In takrat bo na sporedu omote naši.
The philosophy of Lexus is really, really go beyond customer expectation. Because for example, you enter the showroom, then the specific cappuccino with, we name it like a hand wiping towel with some sweets. And cappuccino come with Lexus logo mark, and this hand cleaning towel shows our welcomeness and give us best comfort to the customer to be well received and spend the time in our showroom as if they are enjoying the quite a comfortable cafe time as they like.
No, LBX pa je z večjimi Lexusi primerljiv tudi s tem prtljažnikom, ki je pač za tako majhen avtomobil kar zelo velik, recimo temu celo ogromen, predvsem pa je bistveno večji kot na primer pri Lexusu UX. Ampak Lexus UX je že dobil tudi električni pogon in Lexus je že napovedal, da bo postal popolnoma električna znamka. In za pokušino, kako bo izgledala Lexusa prihodnost, pa se zapeljimo po škotski s UX-om, s vašim naslednjim klikom.